watching WFTDA-TV. I am with Bam Bam.
Good morning, Bam Bam. Good morning. How do you say good morning in your...
Bonjour.
Wow. See, I just want to get that started. I'm so excited.
Makes you think of croissants and fresh coffee. Bonjour.
See, where I come from, it's croissants.
Croissants.
And usually gas station coffee. So, okay. So that's why I want to bring a little bit of what you bring to our early morning. So we want to thank you all for joining us here. Day two of the East Region Playoff, the Sugar Bush Showdown here in Essex Junction, which is in Burlington, Vermont.
That's right. Yeah. Not too far from us. At last, we only had to drive 2 hours this time.
A little bit easier on the travel budget, I am sure.
So this morning,
yes,
we are about to watch Dutchland versus Montreal.
Yes, and I believe, again, we're going to have the wonderful bilingual call. Thank you again for doing that.
Dutchland yesterday coming off a loss to Carolina, 304-75. And Montreal, a very closely contended bout until about 10 minutes till the end, which ended in London taking it 191-122.
Mm-hmm. I think that what we're going to see today is determination from both of these teams in that sense that nobody wants to go to the last place bracket. I think that you definitely have that fire coming in, as any team does. But now you're here, your first game on Saturday, which means you don't want to end up being first game on Sunday.
No. No, but that would still mean number 9 and number 10 in a region that now has, 37 or 40 teams contending in it? So
very true.
Not so bad, not so bad. It's just it would be 9 or 10 in this tournament. Montreal last year placing 6th, the year before placing 7th. So they definitely want to move it up. And Dutchland last year placing 8th, mm-hmm. and the year before placing 10th in 2010.
Mm-hmm. So again, teams that are not too unfamiliar to having that little bit of a struggle to get farther up into that 1-5 range. But as you certainly mentioned, this is certainly one of the more difficult regions. I mean, you have some very old teams, very storied teams, very often victorious teams. So I think that that's always the challenge for any team coming in, is those bouts. They really matter as you go forward. But again, you're still in the top 10 in the East region. That is, in and of itself, a remarkable feat.
Yes. Why don't we go through the roster?
Absolutely.
Let me read off the Montreal roster. Number 1, X Mange-Molecule. Number 11, Bone Machine. 118, Trash and Smash. Number 2, Little Mama. Number 2000, Apocalypstic. Number 289, Cheese Grater. Number 40 ounce, Georgia W. Tush. 454 grams is Chasing Amy. 516, Iron Wench. 658, Surgical Strike. Number 8, Jess Bandit, The Captain. Number 8080, Greta Bobo. Aou, that's A-O-O-U, is Tilu. AK-47 is Assassinista.
I still love how well you can say "au" and keep it that low and controlled. It's remarkable.
I'm a singer.
Oh, that's it. Dutchland side, they're going to be wearing the black. That is 0202, Punk Sutani. Number 11 is Spinal Snap. 1793, Marie Antoinette. Number 18 is Skid Ho. 1834, Spanish in Collision. 1959 is Laverne and Surly. 21 is Jose Cuervo. Number 40, Twisted Scissors. 404 is J.K. Trolling. 65 is KT Boundary. 750, Slammin' Shots. 777, Treasure Chest. 968 is Porsche Blockster. And 99, Bella Loblowski. Want to remind you, if you want to give us a little bit of feedback on your feed at home, you want to let us know what you're thinking, how it's looking, all of those factors, let us know. Hashtag Talk2WFTDA. Talk to the number WFTDA.
And if you are listening to the Boutcast, the audio only, you can upgrade for $12 to watch the wonderful images of the bout that we're about to see, as well as the next 2 days. It's worth it. 2 days left of tournament play. Right today, we've got 6 bouts. Tomorrow, 5 bouts. So that's 11 bouts for $12. $1.08 per bout. I think it's worth it.
Oh, decidedly. Yeah, as the times we have left. Also, we are going to have archives that are going to be available on the website, WFTDA.tv. So definitely something to consider as we move forward. You have a playoff regional next weekend as well. Going to be the South Central, the 4th of 4. Then we're going to take a little break. As we all can imagine, we need to, you know, get back to reality, pay some bills ourselves. And then we're going to have, in Atlanta, the Championship. Very excited for that. So it looks like we're just about to get started.
We sure are. On the Jamline 2000, Apocalyptic for the New Skids on the Block and Skid Ho for the Dutchland Blitz. Bon match, mesdames et messieurs. Apocalyptic toujours pris au piège dans le peloton. Skid Ho également derrière un mur de verre. Skid Ho à l'avant du peloton, derrière Mange-moi le cul, derrière Cheese Grater maintenant. La dernière bloqueuse pour les Skid, et elle passe! Première jammeuse, Skid Ho, pour le Dutchland Blitz.
Skid Ho is your lead jammer for Dutchland. Took her a little bit of a while to get through the pack, but she was able to do that nice bit of work getting around Cheese Grater of Montreal at the last moment. Almost able to break through, and finally is, as Apocalyptic, number 2,000 in the green for Montreal, but jammer is coming back in for Dutchland, and almost through, and then she's got someone getting right in front of her at the last possible moment. Nice play from Surgical Strike.
But she did score 3 points, and Montreal zero. Montreal having a hard time with the defense right off the bat. And right now, the New Skids on the Block will line up Iron Wench and number 404 for Dutchland, J.K. Trolling.
We might lose our feet here for a moment, but we'll be right back with you. We're going to just keep on keeping on. So we have got number 404 on our line. That is J.K. Trolling. She's going to be jamming for Dutchland. She's going up against the amazing Iron Wench I got to see yesterday. And Iron Wench very quickly proving why she is so amazing. She is already your lead jammer.
Et J.K. Trolling à la derrière le mur de verre. Et Iron Wench passe presque une dernière bloqueuse pour Dutchland. C'est Twisted Scissors et c'est fait. 5 points, un grand slam pour les New Skids on the Block.
Iron Wench is already through. She's got 5 points. She's got the grand slam. Nice bit of work by the final wall of Dutchland right there. Twisted Scissors makes a bit of a play, is also able to do it again. Nice bit of a sternum, leans in with the shoulder, bumps her out. Iron Wench with a smart call. She got just over the line, pulls herself back around and decides to make a break for it.
J.K. Trolling toujours derrière le mur de New Skids on the Block. Ça ne passe pas pour Dutchland. Iron Wench, 5 autres points. Un deuxième grand slam, ça fait 10 points.
Iron Wench able to pick up a second grand slam, looking to see if she can get a third, and I believe she has exactly that. 15 points on this pass so far. Jammer still yet to break through for Dutchland. Nice defense coming out strong early this morning for Montreal.
Et Jess Bandit qui recycle J.K. Trolling à l'arrière du peloton. Iron Wench qui se prend un autre grand slam. Ça fait 20 points. Et non, il n'y a pas de power jam encore, mesdames et messieurs. C'est Iron Wench qui ne cesse de dépasser le peloton au complet. Et la défense de Montréal qui retient très bien J.K. Trolling.
We have Iron Wench with another grand slam. She's got about 25 seconds. She's in the middle of the pack now. The pack has spread itself out quite a bit. Nice bit of bridging by Dutchland there. Though, usually you would think Montreal would want to get a little bit more power forward. They were able to do that, and that is what has Iron Wench through.
Et là, c'est devenu très difficile pour J.K. Trolling qui prend plusieurs coups et qui ne peut pas passer. 11 Bone Machines s'en vont au banc des punitions pour un blocage illégal. Et ça fait 2 minutes. Mesdames et messieurs, 30 pour Montréal et 3 pour Dutchland. 30 points pour Iron Wench.
Indeed, 30 points for Iron Wench. You can see on your screen, that is how she does it. She's able to maintain herself. She holds her arms out of the way. She uses them effectively and then makes sure she does not foul. Incredibly smart jamming. 30 points for Montreal. That was a 30-point jam. 3 points for Dutchland. 26 to play in this first half.
Et maintenant, on a Greta Bobo pour Montréal. Et numéro 99, Bella Loblowski pour Dutchland.
I could listen to you say Greta Bobo all day, Patrick.
Greta Bobo.
And if we are lucky, we're going to get the opportunity to hear it again. She is trying to get through the pack. Gets recycled to the outside. Has to pull herself back around. But Bella Loblowski is through and your lead jammer for Dutchland.
Et Greta Bobo qui est toujours aux prises avec la défensive. Non, c'est fait. Greta Bobo dépasse le peloton. Les deux jammeuses en position de côté des points. Bella Loblowski entre dans le peloton. Elle est poussée à l'extérieur par Little Mama. Et juste avant que Greta Bobo revienne dans le peloton pour compter des points, elle arrête le jam et prend 2 points.
I think that was a smart call as Bella Loblowski goes into the pack, realizes she can't get much farther, decides to call it, picks up 2 points. keeps Montreal from putting any more on the board. So that's Montreal 30, Dutchland 7.
Yeah, protecting her own points. Nice pack awareness. She had to look backwards while you're trying to negotiate passing that pack. That can't be easy.
Well, especially when you're doing the short side between one and two, to be able to make sure you're staying in bounds, look back. That's some great awareness.
Yeah. Tilou for Montreal. Twisted scissors pour Dutchland. Et Tilou poussée à l'extérieur. Elle revient en jeu après une douloureuse chute. Mais elle passe. Tilou, première jammeuse pour les New Kids on the Block.
Tilou is jamming for Montreal. She has gotten through. She is your lead jammer. Twisted Scissors has got two in front of her for Montreal, trying to see. Oh, it looks like the three wall will not form because we have a little bit of a gap happening. I think nice play there from that
Trash
is Trash
and Smash.
Of course
bridging,
it is.
Yes. Et Tilou passe le peloton, prend ses points. 4 points, 4 points for Tilou. Calls off the jam as Twisted Scissors was actually a little bit far back, but why waste time this early in the game?
I think that we have certainly opportunities where you want to burn clock, and there's time in which, you know, if you have things going in your favor, you want to maximize as much as you can. So I agree with you.
Yeah, it's a bit early to burn now.
Yeah, that is a smart call. 34 points already for Montreal, 5 points for Dutchland.
23 minutes 56 left on the clock. And we've got Apocalyptic pour Montréal et Skid Ho pour le Dutchland Blitz. Apocalyptic veut prendre la revanche de son dernier jam et passe le peloton, la première, très rapidement. Skid Ho toujours aux prises avec le peloton des New Skids.
Apocalyptic is your lead jammer. She is through on a scoring pass right now, picking up 5-point Grand Slam. Skid Ho not having a lot of luck as she was recycled outside, has to come back around at turn number one and two, still in the pack as Apocalyptic's trying to make another pass.
A surgical strike au banc des punitions pour une pénalité majeure. Il y a trois bloqueuses pour les New Skids, quatre pour le Dutchland Blitz. Et Apocalyptic, un autre grand slam. 5 points pour les New Skids. Et Skid Ho toujours aux prises avec la défensive de Montréal, c'est-à-dire Little Mama. Oh, un blocage qui avait presque l'air illégal, mais Little Mama est passé à l'extérieur.
Little Mama mixing it up with the Dutchland jammer Skid Ho. Having a little bit of fun at the back of the pack. First thing in the morning, but Apocalyptic was through. She picked up 5 points on the pass, now 4 points on that. So that's going to be a nice bit of a run, moving them continuously forward. Montreal had a bit of a interesting game yesterday, had a nice strong start. London is able to power back against them. So I think I don't really want to say they have something to prove, but I think they almost want to prove it to themselves.
Yeah, they want to avenge yesterday's loss, which was, you know, to some of them, I think they considered yesterday's game to be the game of their season. Mm-hmm. It was kind of what they were working towards, whether, you know, they had to go up against Steel City or London or, you know, any other team. And unfortunately, they lost to London. But right now, an Iron Wench pour les New Skids on the Block et JK Trolling pour Dutchland. Très facilement, Iron Wench prend le statut de première jammeuse.
Iron Wench is out first, and she's already back around the track. Jammer for Dutchland hasn't even had an opportunity to find any openings whatsoever. Ooh. Not even a lot of luck making them. Iron Wench is around once already for 5 points. Wait to see JK Rowling trying to make a nice move to the inside. Leans her shoulder in, gets a sternum bump on number 8 for Montreal and is finally through, but we have the second scoring pass coming up right now for Montreal.
Iron Wench passe le peloton une dernière fois. Arrête le jam après 4 autres points. Ça fait 9 points pour Iron Wench. Another great slam for a great jam from Iron Wench.
We can't tell if they're grand slams or not sometimes. She keeps putting up fours or fives so quickly. Dutchland is still going to hold at 5 points. Montreal at 57. 21 left to play in our first half.
Et pour le prochain jam, on a Greta Bobo. Greta Bobo. Et Bella Lebloski pour Dutchland. Et c'est parti, une bloqueuse de moins par équipe. Facilement, Greta Bobo passe tout le monde à l'extérieur. Il y avait une grande ouverture et Greta Bobo l'a prise.
Nice bit of work from the front of the pack for Montreal. Everybody started to make a shift to the left, and I think that you had that first line of defense for Montreal started. That opens up an easy pass for Greta Bobo to get on the outside, get Grand Slam just that quickly. And it seems that's a continual pattern. They're getting out quickly. They're getting through quickly. Dutchland just continuing to struggle, not even through the pack yet. Just great, great defensive awareness and play for Montreal.
Hey, bam, bam, on a le premier super jam du match. En fait, le premier super jam, the first power jam for the New Skids this tournament because they had none from London. And it belongs to Greta Bobo.
It's a super jam indeed for Greta Bobo.
Et les New Kids qui arrêtent complètement le peloton. Greta Bobo, 5 points. Et maintenant, les deux équipes à pleine capacité, 4 bloqueuses pour les deux.
I think an interesting change here for Dutchland is they no longer have to focus on helping their jammer become much more effective in that defensive position. Great holding back. Montreal, though, able to break it up, at least break that wall, that linear plane, and give it a little bit of room for the jammer to kind of weave in and out, but she's been able to be effective. We'll see if she can do it one more time.
Et oh, à l'extérieur, et oh, la dernière bloqueuse, la capitaine du Dutchland Bliss Kid Ho, empêche Greta Bobo de passer le peloton, mais elle prend quand même 4 points, still 4 points on that pass, even though she was pushed to the outside.
And I think that that was very smart. Greta Bobo was in a position she had gotten bumped out. She realized that she wasn't going to have an easy opportunity to get back in, though she could have because the aggressor had also been knocked out.
That's right.
But it was just one of those, you know what, we still have an advantage. I can call it now. I don't have to work. We're going to have our jammer on the line with 81 points for Montreal, 5 points for Dutchland.
And I think she did want to call it off before the opposite jammer was able to come out of the box so that Tsilu would have an easier time getting through quicker.
Exactly, and she does just like that. But again, a wise Montreal pulls over to the side and just waits. They know that Tsilu can make the pack move forward, or what is left of the pack, and that would be Dutchland, who happens to have their jammer out once again. And of course, that is Bella Lobolowski still.
Et Bella Lobolowski qui passe le peloton facilement dans le premier, la première révolution. Elle revient et est-ce que Tsilu est première jammeuse? Oui, elle peut arrêter le jam. Et c'est exactement ce qu'elle fait, mais je pense que non, il n'y a pas de points. No points for Dutchland on this one. They were close enough, but no cigar.
Dutchland is definitely taking a little time to get warmed up this morning. It seems as though they were moving a little slower. They picked up their pace. They picked up their step. I think just kind of getting an opportunity for the pack and the defensive to just focus as a group that way has really helped them to kind of solidify where they want to be this morning. I mean, we've already been doing this for about 12 minutes, 86-5 right now. Dutchland's got some points they certainly need to make up, but we'll see if what can happen is you have Apocalypsics out for Montreal right now. She's been very effective this weekend.
Yeah, she's been working really hard. They've been working hard. Oh, and interesting tangle between She's Greater and number 21, Josie Cuevro. And, oh, Apocalypstic takes a nasty spill on the outside.
Blocker draws the major for that. So that is the pivot going out to the box right now. Spinal snap. Apocalypstic is your lead jammer. Pivot is going out for Montreal. We are still waiting to see what we can do with Punxsutawney.
And the defense from Dutchland kind of going into overdrive. It looks like they're getting frustrated. It's, you know, when you start to hit harder and you take more chances, it feels a little more dangerous, but you have to keep it together. Again, Dutchland in the black, Montreal in the green.
We have Skid Ho, number 18 for Dutchland on the line. Iron Wench, number 5, 16. You should all be familiar with that name by now in the green and magenta leopard print leotard. It's a tiger stripe.
Montreal at 90, Dutchland at 5 points. Les deux jammeuses derrière un mur défensif. Et Skid Ho poussé à l'extérieur par Chasing Amy. Également, Iron Wench poussé à l'intérieur. Et, oh, et 18-34, Spanish in Collision. Spanish in Collision pousse Iron Wench à l'extérieur. Elle coupe la piste, track cut. She lands in the box. It's a power jam for Skid Ho.
Indeed, and that is exactly what they need. Nice bit of a defense, Dutchland. It does indeed put Iron Wench in the box. She's going to be sitting for 1 minute, so it is a power jam. We're going to see Skid Ho make a nice move to the outside, keep her skates in bounds, which is surprising. She was riding that edge for a long time on corner number two, but she's able to maintain her track position. Entering the back of the pack, looking for some assistance now as the pivot has also entered.
Et ça fait 5 points pour Skid Ho. La défensive des New Skids qui est à 4 contre 2. Et ça passe quand même pour Skid Ho.
And just as quickly as that, snap, the pivot for Dutchland goes back to the penalty box. She is on a rough start earlier this morning.
Et on retient Bone Machine à l'arrière du peloton. Little Mama recycle Skid Row à l'arrière du peloton. Et Aaron Wench revient au jeu. Power Jam is over. Et facilement, Aaron Wench passe le peloton. Elle n'est pas première jammeuse. C'était son passage initial. That was her initial pass.
Mm-hmm. Does not get a chance to come around to score any points. It looks like 3 points go for Dutchland. So we have Montreal at 90, Dutchland at 13, halfway through our first half.
So not a bad job containing that power jam, nevertheless.
If you would like to check out the Bracket Bonanza Sponza, I would suggest you go to 2-in-1 Skate Shop. That is 2-in-1 Skate Shop, P-E on the end. Take 10% off your entire order at 2-in-1 Skate Shop with the coupon Bonanza. Shock the competition, 2-in-1 Skate Shop.
On a Bella Leblowski et Greta Bobo au jam. À l'avant du peloton, c'est Greta Bobo qui passe la première jammeuse. Greta Bobo pour les New Kids on the Block.
Greta Bobo is out first. She is your lead jammer. We have someone from the pack for Dutchland going out to the penalty box, which is not good because they have one in there already. So not a lot of assistance we're going to have for Bella Leblowski as she is through the pack on her initial pass, but right behind her scoring 4 points, Montreal.
And Greta Bobo qui veut... Oh! Greta Bobo qui voulait prendre le cinquième point. Mais attend un peu tard. Greta Bobo wanted to get that fifth point, but waited a little bit too long and let Dutchland pick up 3 points on that one.
And unfortunately did not even get the fifth point, as far as I can tell. So it looks like it is just four for Montreal. Yeah.
That was greed.
Hubris, thy color is neon green.
No, greed.
As we see Montreal again being awarded lead jammer status, she's going to be able to come back around. That is T. Lou waiting to see where the jammer for Dutchland even is. Oh, and she is going around on the outside. This is a power jam for Montreal.
Yes, that is Twisted Scissors going to the penalty box. C'est un super jam pour les New Kids de Montréal. Et maintenant à 4 bloqueuses, 4 blockers for Montreal, 2 for Dutchland. Very difficult situation for Dutchland right now as they only have 2 blockers in the pack.
Third is just able to enter toward the back. And it looks like we have a major block. We called on someone. It looks like it was not the jam. Someone. Always good when the refs are having a little bit of communication from the outside to the inside. We like to see that. We have T. Lou coming in now. She's got that 3-wall huddled up a little bit more. Not so much a wall, but a cluster to have to get around. But she's able to do it. 5-point Grand Slam Montreal.
And number 96, Porsche Blocker. Porsche Blockster comes back to play. The New Skids hold her. Ils prennent la chèvre, Porsche Blockster, et retiennent la bloqueuse. Ils retiennent le peloton par la même occasion. T. Lou, un troisième Grand Slam.
Green Montreal, they had a nice bit of a wall, which I think was smart at the get-go to make sure nobody could get back too far. They pull themselves out of the way, just huddling up in the corner. T. Lou is not able to do a full run, but she's able to get a fair amount of points, so she does get 4. We do have a...
19.
Mm-hmm.
Et Dutchland demande un temps de pause. Dutchland calls for a timeout.
Dutchland.
I think I would too.
I would think that this is definitely a good time. You know, you get 3, you've got 11 and a half left to play. You're definitely trying and things are not working. You can see they're making minute adjustments, but it seems as though they need a bigger step. They need a bigger change.
Yeah.
They need to be able to counter the runaway jamming from Montreal.
Yeah, I think, you know, to a degree, they want to better Carolina's score against Dutchland, which was 304-75. And, it seems like they're on their way.
We want to remind you that Rydell is the official skate of the WFTDA. Unmatched quality and unmatched performance. That is Rydell. And also, always striving to exceed your expectations. That, of course, is Vanilla Derby. They are now available with the upgraded Italian leather. A little more breathable. Stretches a little more. I know a couple of people who have tried them. Absolutely like them. VanillaSkates.com. We have 122 points for Montreal. 16 points for Dutchland. 11, 37 left to play in our first half.
And a new jammer for Dutchland, KT Boundary, versus an overworked jammer, Apocalyptic, for Montreal.
And again, we start with the no-pack situation. So as they start to move forward, Apocalyptic's making a move to the outside, not getting any leeway whatsoever. Jennifer Dutchland is almost able to make it, gets pushed out and down at corner number two. A couple of quick whistles happening, but it looks like Apocalyptic on the outside is able to make something for herself. She is your lead jammer, Montreal.
Et Katie Boundary aux prises avec Surgical Strike et ça passe finalement pour Dutchland. Apocalyptic approche le peloton. Oh, reste à l'intérieur, mais un pied à l'extérieur. Malheureusement, super jam pour Dutchland. Apocalyptic au banc des punitions pour avoir coupé la piste.
And Dutchland does get the power jam because of a nice move from Skid Ho. She gets a bit of a bump on the jammer. Apocalyptic goes outside, spins in too quickly. Major cut. She goes to the penalty box. We have Dutchland's jammer get knocked down, but she was able to maintain and then gets 5 points. So she gets back up. She's all the way around looking for another Grand Slam, and they need to take advantage of these power jams.
Yeah, this is when you make up the points that you so badly want. And oh, on the outside, Skid Ho clears the way for her jammer. Ça fait 5 points pour Katie Boundary.
We have a major black buck set up, though. Jammer gets through.
Incredible. Katie Boundary qui fait le zigzag autour de du mur de Montréal et passe très facilement entre les bloqueuses.
Nice work, Dutchland, pushing her player into another, trying to fence off a little bit too close, however. Not going to be able to draw the 20 feet. Apocalyptic is out of the pack. She is through. She had, again, already had her scoring pass, so now that is a four-point pass.
Et Apocalyptic était première jammeuse. Elle était au banc des punitions, donc il n'y a pas de première jammeuse pour ce jam. On ira pour les 2 minutes. This will be a 2-minute jam. Since the lead jammer, who was Apocalyptic, was sent to the penalty box, therefore canceling her lead jammer status. And there is only one lead jammer status awarded per jam.
You get one. I think that was very good timing, though, for Apocalyptic, who got knocked down and was sprawling flat past corner number two. As you can see on your screen here, nice little bit of celebration. Dutchland happy with how that worked out. Seems as though the timeout a little bit beneficial for Dutchland as they now slide up to 34 points. Montreal at 131, 9 to play.
Et on a Iron Wench pour Montréal versus Twisted Scissors pour Dutchland. Iron Wench est envoyée au tapis, mais elle se relève aussitôt. Et c'est Treasure Chest qui essaie de prendre Iron Wench, mais elle passe première jammeuse, Iron Wench.
Iron Wench is your lead jammer. She got a little bit of a tangle up there with Marie Antoinette, who was able to get back in. She's not going to get a penalty for that, which is great, as we have Dutchland's jammer now through. Twisted Scissors all the way around at the back. 4-point pass, though, for Montreal in the meantime.
The Twisted Scissors toujours au prix avec la défensive. Derrière Jess Bandit. Et Chasing Amy qui fait le pont. Iron Wench entre dans le peloton. Prend ses points un à un et elle contourne. Non, elle ne contourne pas la jammeuse. Twisted Scissors. Oh! Il y a les deux jammeuses. Iron Wench qui veut ralentir Twisted Scissors.
Jammer on jammer action. Iron Wench is right in front of Twisted Scissors and just decides to slow her down. You're like, you know what? Sometimes we can take time to play. We have to remember this is fun.
I think she was going for the dirty eat the baby strategy. Oh, yeah. So the Twisted Scissors se ramasse au tapis.
I'm surprised Twisted Scissors didn't get, maybe that's what that fourth minor was for.
Yep.
She flung a skate pretty high when she tripped. So it was all about how the contact came in. So she has her fourth minor. So this is a power jam for Montreal and Iron Wench. She's got 20 seconds to go. She can definitely ride this one out, and they'll have plenty of time next jam.
So the power jam is really becoming a story in this bout, which is an interesting contradiction to yesterday.
I think it really, the term super jam is really starting to apply.
Et Iron Wench qui arrête le jam avec 5 autres points.
5 more points for Iron Wench. That's going to take Montreal to 154, Dutchland at 38. If you have time and you decide you want to go to derbyforall.com, you will find experienced derby skaters getting you the right gear to take you to the next level. They mount plates. They can really help you do all of the different things. You want to find their facilities. It's at derbyforall.com.
And on the talk to WFTDA.com, somebody's asking, how do you say call it? En français, I would say arrête.
French for stop the madness.
Yep.
Jammer through for Montreal. It looked like the pack didn't even move. Dutchland just deciding to hold still. Greta Bobo had a easy time once. She almost is able to do it again. Nice bit of a shove there. Spanish in collision. Lives up to the name. Pushes her to the inside. Greta Bobo is able to recycle herself around midway through. But it looks like there was a major back block during that process.
Oui. Greta Bobo au banc de punition. Ce qui fait la rotation des jammers. Et c'est Twisted Scissors qui revient au jeu pour le Dutchland Blitz. Et c'est un super jam pour Twisted Scissors.
Twisted Scissors was just about to stand in the penalty box anyway, so that means that it wasn't a full minute, but we have Montreal's jammer going to be about 50 seconds, give or take. Dutchland catches a little bit of a break there as no pack was called. I think that was good play from the pack moving backward. Dutchland, again, using Montreal's strategy against them. They just huddle up, they move to the side, make the jammer work, but it's effective.
And Twisted Scissors trying to make her way through the pack. Georgia W touch the last line of defense for Montreal. Et c'est une mineure de blocage au dos pour Twisted Scissors, mais ce n'est qu'une mineure. Après quatre mineures, on s'en va en banc des punitions.
Twisted Scissors picks 5 points on that last pass. She also happens to get a minor back block call, and I think that was a great call from the ref. As you can see on your screen, if you're watching on the high definition feed, you would be able to see how she came in a little too hot, makes a bit of a bump, readjust, but it was a minor.
Et Greta Bobo de retour au jeu. Oh! On n'a pas vu Greta Bobo passer. 5 points pour les New Skids. Un super jam surprise de Greta Bobo.
Super jam surprise. That's going to be in our Derby cookbook, I think. As we have Greta Bobo again going through. She had been released from the pack. Gets through. Picks up 2 points on that pass. It is negated by the 2 points of Dutchland, however. So we are under the 5 minute mark in our first half. Montreal 161, Dutchland 45. It looks like Dutchland had a little bit of a run, and then it was squashed.
Yeah, well, I think both teams are looking to control their power jam situations, their major penalties for jammers. A lot of power jams allowed, awarded in this game so far.
And it's surprising when you look at the penalties, which we'll be able to talk about in just a minute. Tilou for Montreal. Not the first one through. That is Dutchland.
Skid Ho.
Skid Ho, indeed.
Yeah. Skid Ho, a real key player for Dutchland. That's why she's the captain.
Because she's able to make smart decisions like that. She hops in, still waiting to see how many points. The ref is like, two.
Two.
Skid Ho with a little victory.
That's but you can zero see. For Montreal.
Mm-hmm. It's those minor victories sometimes. She gets in, she gets this close as she can, and then she decides to call it. She's able to pick up two on that pass. Again, you can hear us for free, but if you want to actually see this game, which is quite exciting, in all honesty, the score does not quite convey as 161 for Montreal, 47 for Dutchland. It's just $12 to get you the rest of the weekend on WFTDA.TV. $12 will get you high-definition feed throughout the entirety of today and tomorrow as well.
And I would say it's quite a physical game. Mm-hmm. Lots of hard hits. Almost like an aggressive sort of hit.
Yes, but what's interesting is that you don't see an awful lot of penalties from that. We're seeing a lot of accruing of minors.
Yeah.
Most of the ones that I've seen are for minor passes. You've got on Montreal, 2 trips, 3 trips, and then everything else is 1.
Yeah.
And on Dutchland, you have a couple of more with 2, and then Treasure Chest at 4. So she definitely has changed her play in this first half.
Yeah. Apocalypse stick pour Montréal et pour Dutchland, c'est JK Trolling. C'est Apocalypse Stick qui est première jammeuse. JK Trolling toujours aux prises avec la défensive. Et ça passe pour JK Trolling, mais Apocalypse Stick est déjà revenu dans le peloton. Et prend ses points. Oh! Et un blocage avec les bras qui envoie la bloqueuse de Dutchland au banc des punitions.
I think that was interesting as we had Spanish in collision. She had a nice bit of a hit on the jammer for Montreal.
On
Apocalypse Stick. She's able to get her into bounds, but they called it as a major forearm, major elbow, so that is going to send her to the pack. We couldn't quite see the angle. It looked solid, but again, if it looks like the forearm, but you just happen to lean with that elbow that much more, that's still going to be a call. So I think that was a good eye from our ref out there. We've got 2 minutes left. in this first half. I want to remind you that roller derby nutrition at its finest, Derbalife.com. It has changed many a derby individual.
On a Iron Wench versus Skid Ho. Les deux jammeuses passent le peloton très facilement. C'est une course de jammeuses. Deux bloqueuses par équipe seulement au peloton. Et Iron Wench arrête le jam et prend trois points. Et Skid Ho prend zéro. Elle a été poussée à l'intérieur du peloton alors qu'elle s'apprêtait à passer. That was a very quick jam.
Well, they got out fast. They were able to get through. And I think that was smart from Iron Wench because she realized that Skid Ho had also gotten through. She gets up. She just gets a couple of quick points. That's three. Yeah. And is able. The timing was good. She's able to hold zero for Dutchland.
It was kind of a gutsy move, actually, mm-hmm. because the blockers mm-hmm. from Montreal were at the back of the pack.
Yes, she could have made a little bit more. But I think, again, not a bad choice because they're able to get one more go-around, and it does almost pay off, but it looks like a major track cut.
Greta Bobo.
Yeah, I thought she had it, but no. Shoveler is saying that she crossed the line.
Et c'est Pang Soutani pour Dutchland qui est en super jam. Her first jam of the day, and it's a power jam. Another power jam.
Pang Soutani trying to make a move now, shuffling back and forth between outside and inside. She's able to get a little bit of communication. Manjwa is a bump, and then that was it. Pang Soutani is able to get around. She gets 5 points. She's going to see if she can get just a couple more. She's got a minute and 13 left in this jam.
Et Spanish in Collision qui revient au jeu. Pang Soutani derrière un mur de New Skids. Et c'est Pang Soutani qui commet une faute majeure, un blocage au dos et s'en va au banc des punitions, ce qui relâchera Greta Bobo.
This is not going to be good for Dutchland as they now have 50 seconds when she sat down. So not only does she have to, the jammer for Dutchland, fulfill this, it's going to run to the halftime. She's going to have about 10 seconds to spend as the game comes back. Greta Bobo is going to take good advantage of it right now. We'll see what happens after the halftime. How many points? Oh, that was the initial pass for Greta Bobo.
The initial pass, yeah. Il y a quatre bloqueuses pour Montréal, seulement deux bloqueuses pour Dutchland. Alors facilement, Greta Bobo prend 5 points à Grand Slam.
Seeing as she comes back around, Pack doing a nice job. Dutchland trying to get behind, Montreal trying to hold up the middle of it.
Et Bella Leblowski qui recycle illégalement. Greta Bobo, elle s'en va au banc des punitions, elle aussi.
Bella Leblowski goes to the penalty box. She was blocking the wrong direction. You cannot do that, so she gets sent out.
A spinal snap also going to the penalty box. This will be an awfully thin pack for Dutchland in the next jam. Actually, at the start of the yes. next period, because we are already at halftime.
Mm-hmm.
And Montreal gathering 178 points, Dutchland 52 in the first half. But let's go into the penalty situation, Bam.
Well, when you look again at Dutchland, they don't have a lot of big numbers, but they have a lot of small numbers. As I can see, there are only three people who haven't been to the penalty box for Dutchland.
Yes.
You have a lot of people who've gone twice. But again, Treasure Chest, she went, and she had those four within the first 15 minutes. She
yeah.
spent many trips there, but she's able to kind of pull that in, and I think that was very smart. She's been a very strong defensive player so far.
Yeah.
But then when you go back and you look at Montreal, you've got a three, you've got a three, and then you've got a lot of ones in there. So I think that they were able to hold it. But when you look at those trips to the penalty box, those are from the jammers. And
yeah.
that's where those power jams have really been able to be effective and help Dutchland get the score that they have now.
I think other teams are looking at this and saying, oh, this team gets a lot of power jams. Mm-hmm. That's a bit of a loophole for us to go into because mm-hmm. if you're not on the jam, you're not scoring. If you're not on the track, you're not scoring.
Yes.
I think they're keeping, Dutchland is keeping Treasure Chest for the second half in case it gets a little bit tighter because
yeah.
she's definitely one of their more experienced players and they want to keep her for the second half should things heat up a little bit mm-hmm. more in the point differential department.
Well, that might happen when you look back at those points. You've got Iron Wench with 65 points contributing at least half, but Greta Bobo not that far behind at 49. So
no.
you've got two strong players, T. Lou also at 33, Apocalyptix at 31. So you've got that nice four rotation, but when you look, they're all contributing. You don't have anybody, aside from Iron Wench, certainly, as
yeah.
the largest contributor, but it's not an easy call to say, you're our go-to. They're all being very solid. When you look on the other side of it, you only have two players that are putting Katie Boundary, who hasn't been jammed that much, but was very effective. She's gotten 18 points so far. Well, Twisted Scissors at 11.
She had that great power jam.
And that's really what did it.
Yeah, definitely.
So we're going to see what happens in our second half. Please stick around. We will be back to conclude Montreal and Dutchland here on WFTDA.TV.
We are back. Dutchland versus Montreal. New Skids on the Block. You are watching Sugarbush Showdown from Burlington, Vermont.
It is lovely here, by the way.
Yes.
You know, people say it's lovely here. It really is. It's lovely here.
So for now, score sitting at 178 for Montreal, 52 for Dutchland. This is the game that will determine who is going to play Boston this evening at 8 o'clock. They are playing for either the fifth or sixth game. Actually, whoever beats Boston goes to the fifth or sixth. And then the loser may end up in the 9-10 bout, and nobody wants that.
Nobody wants that. Patrick, we were talking a little bit about the differences in power jams and how there weren't many differences, about the same amount evenly distributed, but it's how they were using those power jams, I think, is the big factor.
Yeah, most definitely. Montreal, I think, was definitely capitalizing a lot more on their power jam, and the defense for Montreal really more efficient in killing Dutchland's power jam opportunities. And mind you, there were too many power jam opportunities for both teams. Mm-hmm. Too many were given up.
And we're going to see how that's going to play. That's, I think, what really happened in our first half. If that can happen in the second half, Dutchland has been able to make some advances because of that, but that still has held them only to 52 points. So, again, Dutchland is at 52. Montreal is at 178. If you are considering a mouth guard, you really want to consider Sisu mouth guards. They are safe, smart, comfy. You can talk and breathe through them, and of course, you can drink. Keep them right in. Drink your water. You got Hydrate out there on the track. SISUGuard.com. That's a little bit of stretching out from Dutchland at the front.
They only have two blockers against his penalties, playing a big role in the Dutchland defense as well as the power jam situation. Montreal, a full pack. Four blockers standing right on the jammer line. We are about to be underway in period number two. That's Tilou versus Skid Ho for Dutchland.
Tilou is first one up into the middle of the pack. She's able to get about that far and gets shot down by the two all in black, but she does get past. She is not your lead jammer. She passed someone not quite fully legally.
Yeah, Skid Ho peut avoir la position de première jammeuse. Dès qu'elle passe, obtient la position de première jammeuse et arrête le jam aussitôt pour empêcher Tilou de compter des points.
I think that was a smart move from Skid Ho. She was just able to get through in time to call it as jammer for Montreal was coming back in. I think that's a very smart play. And as we saw at the end of the last period, it looked as though they were going to start in the penalty box. Must have fulfilled that minute. So I think, again,
I guess so.
A good break for them in that regard. But either way, Skid Ho, smart play as she moves that much closer to not letting that lead get that much bigger. Apocalypstics, number 2,000, in the green for Montreal.
And JK trolling for Dutchland. Et encore une fois, trois blocus pour chaque équipe. Et c'est Apocalypstics qui passe la première. JK trolling dépasse Little Mama. Les deux jammeuses en position de côté des points. C'est Apocalypstics qui entrera dans le peloton la première. Elle passe facilement. Est-ce qu'elle arrête le jam? Non, on continue. Et Surgical Strike qui envoie JK Trolling à l'intérieur. Et, oh, JK Trolling au banc des punitions. C'est un autre super jam pour les New Skids on the Block.
Nice bit of work from Apocalypstics. She's able to get through. She gets lead jam. She already had picked up some points. She now makes another 5-point pass. The jammer, JK Trolling, is trying to move on the inside line. Corner number three of the track. She gets knocked in. She cuts. She is then sent to the penalty box. Another 5-point pass right there for Montreal. That's going to take them up to 194.
And still, only two blockers for Dutchland. That's got to be difficult when you're trying to kill that power jam and there's only two of you.
Yes. A very adamant 5 points from our ref again for Montreal and Apocalypstics as she's coming in. What's interesting, I think, we see is that smart pack control. Montreal is realizing that they can move forward. They don't have to stop. They don't have to back up. There are those times we've seen them definitely cluster up, move to the outside wall, and then we see occasions where they can just say, you know what, we're going to hold our position. We're going to really start to make any openings we need because you only have those two out there for Dutchland. Yeah. And I think, Patrick, you're absolutely right. Just two, you can't continue to play Montreal that way, and that's how this game has gone so far in the second half.
Surgical Strike doing an excellent job as the O being the offense. And the line was staying back, but Surgical Strike was going in there to mess things up with the defense of Dutchland. And now you've got the Iron Wench. Look at that. With two blockers from Dutchland, only two blockers.
Greta Bobo went for intentional fourth. We have now the pivot coming back in for Dutchland. Makes it at least three, but not enough to make any damage for 5 points for Montreal.
Et J.K. Trolling qui revient au jeu. Derrière les trois bloqueuses de Montréal, Iron Wench revient au peloton. J.K. Trolling doit faire son passage initial pour compter des points. Et pendant ce temps, Iron Wench continue de compter des points. Oh! On the ground, springs back up. Iron Wench continues the damage on the power jam.
She definitely has a nice bit of bounce to her. She gets down and she springs right back in. She's coming around now as we have nice bit of hustle for Dutchland. That is Porsche Blockster, kicks in the turbo and is able to stay ahead, making a little bit of a problem for Jammer to come through for Montreal, but she does not hold it that long. It's a 4-point pass, initial pass right there for J.K. Trolling. Doesn't really matter.
And now Montreal is trying to kill some time because Iron Wench could have called that jam at least, 20 seconds before, but she decided to let it go, let the jammer for Dutchland try and catch up to the pack and called it off just before she was about to enter.
And we had talked about there were opportunities earlier in this game for Montreal to burn some clock, and it certainly didn't pay off. Do you think now, even though you've got 25 minutes, you have a significant lead, you're not seeing any tides turn. Do you think it's a good idea to burn a little bit more and build some pressure?
Well, I think if you've got 170 points ahead, you can afford that.
It doesn't hurt?
Yeah.
We have jammer through for Dutchland. She is out in front as your lead. That is Twisted Scissors, though Tilou very closely behind her, about 3 seconds different, if even that. Coming back around to the pack, you have the three wall in the black right there. Did she get in or past? I don't think so.
No, very efficient block by Greta Bobo on Twisted Scissors, sending her to the outside and protecting those points, because if she had passed one player, she would have gotten the ghost point in the penalty box.
But it seemed as though she, before she made that much of an attempt, she got past her own, realized she was coming in so fast, and she called it. So I was curious if she had just realized it was that much pressure to say, you know what, I don't want to lose any more ground. I don't want to get, because if she comes past and gets one, she would also get, Montreal would then get the two.
Yeah.
So I think perhaps the smart call.
Et très rapidement, apocalyptique pour les New Skids, passe le peloton et devient première jammeuse. Pour le Dutchland Blitz, on a Skid Ho, la capitaine, qui effectue son passage initial également. Mais apocalyptique est déjà en train de compter des points. Elle dépasse le peloton. Est-ce qu'elle arrête le jam? Non. Apocalyptique carries on. You know, that's a strategy that I see Steel City use a lot, where the jammer is substantially ahead of the opposite jammer. They would just continue to skate and rack up points and trust the defense to stop the jammer from the opposite team.
Looks like the penalty boxes are almost empty. Just one left for Montreal. Jammer for Dutchland about halfway through the pack has the wall of green. Nice maneuvering again. Trash and Smash really holds court toward that front. And she just, even though the jammer's down, she just stops and looks at her.
Yep.
Stay down.
Yeah. Apocalyptique de retour dans le peloton en train de compter des points.
You can see Apocalyptique right there just kind of holding up on the screen there, waiting to see if she wants to go for it. She's got enough time. And I think, again, that was a smart holdup, Patrick.
Yeah. Et c'est 5 points quand même pour Apocalyptique qui arrête le jeu. Et oh, Skid Ho qui tente d'arrêter le jeu. Elle n'est pas première jammeuse. Mineure, illégale, procédure illégale, sa quatrième mineure. She lands in the box after a fourth minor. She thought she was lead jammer.
It looks as she's in the box. Either she thought she was or she was just putting her hands on her hips right there.
I don't know.
Both teams calling timeouts right there. Though it got assessed to Montreal, I think Dutchland may have caught just a little bit of a break right there because they're not ending up using one of theirs. Montreal's bench came out just a little bit faster. And it looks like it is going to be a challenge, and it has switched to an official timeout. You can talk to thousands of Derby fans if you'd like to advertise on WFTDA.tv. Affordable packages are available for your business, boot camp, or tournament advertising. Visit WFTDA.com, sponsorship opportunities, to learn more. WFTDA.com, we want to thank you for joining us again here on WFTDA.tv. We have 22:50 left to play. And I think, again, a good time. You know, you have that type of communication error going on. You need to call it, even if you are Dutchland, to say, we can't lay down. Montreal, I think, is not a bad idea to say, here, there were some issues. You can still be up by 170 points. And it's like, you know what? You have to control the game. If you see it going in an erroneous direction, as a bench, you have to use that timeout.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, but now I wonder what it's going to come down with. That was an interesting call where she got sent to the penalty box.
And it was interesting. I actually happened to be looking just in that direction as she did. And I could see it going either way. In all honesty, it's like she made a motion toward her hip, kind of, and then she put her hand on her hip. And Shoveler right then said, no, you were trying to call it. And I couldn't tell if she was saying, wait, you said I was lead or I wasn't. There was some obvious type of issue that was going on.
Or was she perhaps just, you know, resting her hands on her hips?
It looks like she's trying to explain that right now to our head ref, Sugar Daddy. And she, it looks like she's trying to explain the difference between her hip and her lower back.
I think she was simply putting her hands on her hips to catch her breath. And
it was
interpreted, and, you know, she's trying to call off the jam.
And again, I can see her point, because it looked like she had her hands toward the very back of her hip. From my perspective, again, I'm not alongside. But from the way that I was looking down the straightaway just about, it looked as though... And she wasn't adamant. And you get a lot of those players, and that's what I like. You know, you people, they do the quick slapper, they do the helmet hips contact. She just had, it was the second time she had put her hand there. So it would be easy to understand how that was kind of a conceivable mistake. But I think that's the distinction they might need to make. Difficult ruling to have to make, especially if you're a ref and you didn't see it.
An interesting fact is that I was, you know, roaming around the ref room earlier yesterday, and Sugar Daddy was commenting on how the jammers had to be more adamant about calling off the jam, making the gesture from, you know, basically their helmets to their hips in a very vigorous way so that there was no confusion onto, you know, are you calling off the jam or not?
Yeah, to avoid this.
Exactly. Well, perhaps we can read about it in Five Stride magazine. Online, in store, in the city that never sleeps. Oh, Five Stride is a store, excuse me.
Oh, Bonnie Thunders.
Bonnie
OMG
Thunders, OMG,
you.
WTF are going to whoop my butt.
They can too. You're all about the same size. You're a lithe bunch. But I tell you, I would look out if I were you. That's fivestride.com. But 5-on-5 Mag, that's
what I meant.
That's the place. They've been around for years. They're the ones you want to talk to. Women's Flat Track Roller Derby Magazine. Subscriptions, of course, are available. 5-on-5 Mag.
And if you are Bonnie Thunders, you can write to us at...
hashtag
talk2wfdda.com and tell me what a bad Patrick I was for making that mistake.
Bad Canadian. It was the translation. It was the, you know, magic.
It was all those fives.
It was all those fives.
Speaking of which, does anybody have five penalties?
Not that I have seen so far.
I believe not. They have Dutchland has not been playing Treasure Chest or Bella Lablowski.
No, not the second half. We have Spanish in Collision, who picked up her fourth on this half. So she's at four. You have four for Treasure Chest, four for Bella. No fours on the side of Montreal, though their threes are going up a little bit. You have Greta Bobo, Little Mama, and...
Bone Machine.
Bone Machine. So as we get back to it, there was no pack. Very quickly, Montreal is able to get through as your lead jammer.
Et c'est Iron Wench qui entre le peloton pour ses points. Le peloton de Montréal reste à l'arrière. Et Iron Wench dépasse le peloton. Est-ce qu'on lui a... Oui, on lui accorde un grand slam. 5 points pour les New Kids on the Block. Et Little Mama qui claire le passage pour Iron Wench. On lui donne 5 autres points. Est-ce qu'on prendra la même? Et cette fois-ci, c'est Georgia Touche qui bouge de l'extérieur. Et oui!
It's like Georgia Tush opened the curtains at the back. You had this wide line of green, and she just leaned it a little bit, makes an easy opportunity. Iron Wench just pushes right through and gets around for another 5-point Grand Slam.
Et Skid Ho de retour au jeu. Georgia Tush la push à l'extérieur. Iron Wench toujours aux prises avec les défensives pour ce passage. Skid Ho doit effectuer son passage initial. C'est son premier passage. Donc, pas de points pour elle. Elle doit quand même dépasser le peloton. Et c'est much harder to get through the pack when it's moving, isn't it? Et Iron Wench dépasse le peloton. On lui donne un autre 5 points. Ça fait 15 points pour Iron Wench.
Another 5 points for Iron Wench, as she is able to go almost back around the pack before Jammer can get through for Dutchland. Dutchland on their initial pass. She's got 15 seconds left. She's going to be able to get some. The question, you know, do you call it right then and there? Do you burn it? I think she's going to, burn
she's
that clock.
She's burning.
Wait until she
get
around. I think that's a smart call for Montreal right now. No reason not to. Every reason to do it. So clarification, what had happened was that Jammer had gone to the box, certainly was contesting. We ended up that there was a minor that was upheld. But then she also got an additional minor for then leaving the penalty box. So what that resulted in is a fourth minor. That is then what sent her. So in essence, she was there. They decided to keep her there to fulfill her fourth minor. So that way, it is all even now.
For leaving the penalty box as she was contesting her penalty? Is that what you mean?
That is all that I can imagine. That is what they That is what they told us.
Greta Bobo pour les New Skids. Et on a Bella Lebloski pour Dutchland Blitz.
Look at those arms go. Greta Bobo just swinging them wildly back and forth, trying to get out as far as she can. But Bella Lebloski just striding very confidently behind her. Greta gets in and she calls it quickly. I think it's that mad grab. It's like you smash a window and just go and hope you don't pick up mittfuls of glass. And it looks like she got 0-0 both ways. Montreal 255. Dutchland is at 60 with 20 minutes left to play.
Bam.
Yes.
I think we are noticing a 2010 start. The blockers lining up behind the pivot line.
It took me a minute to say, what are they doing? Maybe they're having a little private conference. I got to tell you a secret, but not here. Though it still happens to work out, Montreal is able to get lead jammer status. Thilou.
Thilou et c'est Skid Ho au jam pour les Dutchman. Non, ce n'est pas Skid Ho, c'est numéro 202. Punxsutawney. Pour le Dutchland Blitz, qui est toujours aux prises avec son passage initial. Thilou, 5 points. C'est un grand slam pour Montréal. Punxsutawney doit effectuer son passage initial pour compter des points. Et elle est toujours derrière le mur de New Skids. New Skids in the green. Dutchland Blitz in the black.
Slam and Shots was just sent to the penalty box for her fourth minor. And that made it a little bit easier for Thilou to get that nice bit of an apex hop. Though she didn't have to go that much, but she wanted to make sure she did it cleanly. She gets a 5-point grand slam on that pass. Jammer gets knocked out of bounds and a little bit of a nice shove on the ref there.
And very easily, Thilou, 5 points, un grand slam pour les New Skids on the block. Ça fait 15 points pour Thilou. Et la jammeuse de Dutchland est toujours aux prises avec la défensive.
Thilou, keeping on, keeping on.
Oh, Thilou à l'extérieur. À l'extérieur, Thilou on the outside, but the blocker that pushed her out fell, so she was able to come right back in, otherwise that would have been a track cut.
And that is exceedingly smart. She was able to have enough wherewithal that she was going into the corner to stop, take a look, realize, and make that. And again, a good call from the ref to recognize that exactly what that was. No pass, no point. No point, no penalty. So, still 4 points, but just like that, she's able to pick up many more, getting ever closer to that 300 mark.
And Punxsutawney having a really hard time with the defense for Montreal. Four blockers working overtime for Montreal, keeping her in the pack. Thilou revient à l'arrière du peloton et facilement... Oh, on la pousse à l'extérieur. Est-ce qu'elle arrête le jam? Non, c'était 2 minutes. That was a 2-minute jam.
I think we ended the end of it. Looked like for a moment there were two more points that had gone up for one of the teams. But again, Dutchland still at 60, so not going to be able to hold so much. So we have Montreal 284. Dutchland is at 60. Fast Girl Skates happens to be the first full-service brick-and-mortar derby store in the world. We bring their extensive in-store experience to you online. They know firsthand how to make your feet happy and skaters fast. FastGirlSkates.com.
On a Skid Ho versus Apocalyptic. au jam. Et oh, un puck à l'épistique. La porte grande ouverte à l'intérieur passe. Et c'est première jammeuse pour Montréal.
Apocalypstics is through as your lead jammer for Montreal. Jammer for Dutchland still caught up in the pack. And that is really going to be the story of this game. Dutchland gets into the pack solidly, and then the green wall closes.
Et il y a Jess Bandit qui joue l'offensive pour les New Skids qui essaie d'ouvrir la porte. Mais, et voilà, c'est fait. Non! Pelle Loblowski qui tente tant bien que mal de pousser Apocalyptic à l'extérieur de la piste, mais Apocalyptic, stable comme le rock, reste à l'intérieur.
Apocalyptic was through. She was able to get past. She had one more jammer, blocker trailing her from Dutchland. They had to let her go, so she's going to get that 5 point easy. Blocker now going out for Dutchland. And that, I think, is also what's been happening. Now we have Skid Ho going out. Looks like it was her fourth minor.
Yeah, blocking skating out of bounds.
Yeah. Skid it out of bounds. Can't do that, so that's going to send her to the penalty box. Power jam again for Montreal.
And Katie Boundary, Apocalyptic is such a stable skater. She was a figure skater, which means she, you know, can land on those skates from very high in the air.
Well, and what's remarkable is that she has such excellent toe-stop control. She can come in and use watch her feet. She just tips them ever forward and then uses the momentum, the wheel step, but the body then goes around so she can curve around people halfway before she moves her skates. That was...
and right when we're saying how great she is, she falls to the inside of the track.
Oh, graceful.
And she calls it off. She's had enough, but you know, that was an 18-point jam for Apocalyptic.
Not too shabby. That's going to take them over the 300 mark. 302. That makes Dutchland still at 60. Sin City Skates. I love saying that because I always have to say it more slowly, which is great for them because then they hear me say Sin City Skates. The first, the best. Happy to fix the screw-ups from the rest. Sin City Skates.
Et on a Iron Wench en power jam, en super jam, excusez-moi. Il y a trois bloqueuses pour Montréal, seulement deux pour Dutchland. Et Iron Wench passe le peloton. Première jammeuse et seule jammeuse en piste pour Montréal.
Pack is pretty much stopped. If you can see on your screen, Green has control of the back. They've been doing this a couple of times so far. They just let the jammer work, and it's been effective. We've seen particularly the Iron Wench, as she's able to get through on that, a five-point pass. She can just keep moving forward. Now you have much more Dutchland presence out there. Montreal shifts gears, pushes everybody to the inside. Even though one got past, Iron Wench just squeezes down between them.
Et Skid Ho passe le peloton, c'est son passage initial. Est-ce que Iron Wench ira pour un dernier passage pour compter des points? Je pense que oui. Et ça continue. Iron Wench n'arrête pas le jam. She's not stopping the jam. She's just carrying on. I guess burning the clock. Et Georgia W. Tush envoie Skid Ho à l'extérieur du peloton. And that's a minor track cut on Skid Ho. No, a major track out on Skid Ho once again, caused by Georgia W. Tush.
Georgia W. Tush, very much one of those players who can draw out those penalties. She's smart, quick, and powerful. We have a five-point pass just like that, and then another, and then another. She's got about 30 seconds left. Iron Wench makes a move to the outside around Georgia W. Tush. Now she's got that wall of three. One of them is able to take a knee. KT Boundary tries to be that, but cannot do it for very long. Iron Wench then moves to the inside and is up around corner number two. And with 10 seconds left, you think, is she going to be able to even make it through? She's all the way halfway back around before the end of this jam.
Easily.
So I want to remind you, talk to WFTDA. It seems, though, Patrick, you have among many new fans.
Yes.
Evil Ed's cat is very happy. He's even sent us a picture. Our cat is addicted to watching Derby and loving him some Plastic Patrick. Let us know what your pets are thinking of this game so far. Hashtag talk to WFTDA. Thank you so much for being here with us this morning, especially around the world, the other side of the country. We're up early here. If you're watching from California, Lord love you.
C'est Greta Bobo pour les New Skids on the Block. La seule jammeuse en piste, the only jammer on the track. Et la défensive de Dutchland qui est très efficace pour le début de ce jam. Greta Bombo does not get through the pack on this one, and Skid Ho, she does get Lee Jammer now, but Skid Ho is back on track.
Skid Ho still looking for any help from Dutchland, and it's almost as though Dutchland is continuing to play Montreal's game, but since it's Montreal's game, they're just being a little bit better at it. Dutchland continuing to back off, making the jammers work. The jammers just aren't having the same effectiveness as Skid Ho. We can see right here, trying to get past. As you can see on your screen, though, Greta Bobo now then is left with that wall of four. Has been effective so far, but I wonder if you really get to that point where losing that step, she's not as quick and responsive. You know, you've been playing for 45 minutes. You get a little tired.
Yeah. And Jess Bandit holding on to Skid Ho for a really long time. Greta Bobo arrête le jam. Après 4 points de plus, Montreal 340, Dutchland 64.
If you're tired of sliding through slippery corners, you need to try the new Villain Wheel from Radar. And also, it just so happens that if you want to pair that up with a great boot, that would be Bont. Bont is the only quality boot. It is made with carbon fiber and fiberglass counters. One piece handmade from the inside out. It's a manufacturing technique that results in the lightest and strongest boots on the market. That is Bont, B-O-N-T.
On a Bela Lebloski versus Thilou at the jam line. Thilou passe la première à l'extérieur. Première jammeuse. Et seulement trois bloqueuses pour Montréal, quatre pour Dutchland. Et Cheese Grater envoie Bela Lebloski à l'extérieur. And I think, does she know? No, it was a minor.
It looks like they were calling a major on the pivot for the contact for Montreal. So she had gone to the penalty box. It was a little confusing for our angle because it looked as though they were chasing after
Bela Lebloski.
Exactly, but I think it was that the contact was on Bela Lebloski, and that's what had Shuttler holding back a little bit. So he's able to get around, catch up, see if any points were going to be awarded. So it looks like they went up to 64 points. Montreal at 348 points, just under 10 minutes left to play. And when you want to play derby at home, you could play Jammer Up. It's the first strategy board game based on modern roller derby. That is jammerup.com.
And now Montreal in a reverse situation. Oh, there we go. No, that's Thilou.
That is Thilou showing her just pushing forward through the pack. Apocalyptic's now on the line for Montreal in the green. Dutchland has a little bit of a move earlier on as it broke apart. The pack almost has an opening, but Twisted Sisters herself just decided to push through on that right. Gets out as she's your lead jammer. A rare thing for Dutchland to be lapping.
There are only two blockers for Montreal to help out the jammer and four for Dutchland. So that's a lot of work for one jammer. Et c'est Twisted Sisters qui prend 5 points. Un grand slam pour Dutchland. Apocalyptic toujours à son passage initial. Et ça n'y est toujours pas pour Apocalyptic. Et Treasure Chest qui revient au jeu, mais immédiatement au banc des punitions.
Twisted Sisters sliding through the inside. Thankfully, she was not called out for that, as it looked like as she was down, it might have been a skate crossing the line, but it did not. So it looks like a 4-point pass. Dutchland's able to pick up. You see on the screen the tired faces for both teams, particularly Dutchland, but still always smiles. Happy to be out here doing it. For you to watch on WFTDA.tv, 73 points for Dutchland, 348 for Montreal. Another great magazine out there is Blood and Thunder Mag. Blood and Thunder is the world's first, happens to also be the largest roller derby magazine, bloodandthundermag.com.
And if you just have to own this game and any other game that will be played this weekend, DVDs of all the games are available online at WFTDA.com for $15. Skid Ho versus Iron Wench. Iron Wench facilement. Première jammeuse pour les New Skids.
Incroyable. I'm trying. We've got 516 Iron Wench. She had that easy move to the inside. She's going to be the lead jammer very quickly. Again, it's all about being aware of movement of the pack from that jumping point, and that's what they did. They all moved right because they were looking for the assistance for Dutchland. Montreal's able to make a move of it. Skid Ho, though, the model of perseverance in this game, just continuing. Even though she can't go forward, she still pushes that direction, trying to get around, but consistent blocking at the back of the pack for Montreal.
Yeah, that was an interesting move. She fell really hard to the ground, laid out on her stomach, and then she got up slowly and turned on the jets and tried to go through the pack. I thought, wow, what, you know, derby determination, mm-hmm. that's it.
Sometimes you go, let me try that again. We have 5-point pass there for Iron Wench. We have the pivot going out right now for Montreal. That is Little Mama. Skidho now around the track. That was her initial pass. There's still a minute left to play. We're going to see what our lead jammer, Iron Wench, decides to do. This is one of those situations you have 7 points. You know, you could burn clock just casually like this. You come back around. We'll see how many more passes they want her to take when you've got almost a 300-point lead.
And Sassanista sent to the penalty box for her fourth minor as Iron Wench cruises through the pack. Only two blockers. Seulement deux bloqueuses pour Montréal. C'est Georgia Touche et Mange-moi le cul.
Iron Wench figuring out which way she's going to go. And I have to give her credit for continuing to push as hard as she does. She certainly doesn't need to. She's got at least 20 seconds, and she runs right up between. But I think that's the time in which you need to do that. You can't wear yourself out, especially as you're looking to move forward.
Yeah.
To play against Boston, as we've seen from the game, the first half of the Boston-Philly game, you have to have that in the back of your mind right now if you're either of these teams, particularly Montreal in this paint.
Taking everybody by surprise, going toe-to-toe with Philly, as a matter of fact, leading Philly for the major part of the first half. Yeah. Shocking everybody here, and I think shocking Philly most of all.
Yeah, I think people were getting a little nervous with their brackets at home. We'll have an update where the brackets are at later on today, but we've got at least 5.5 to play as Apocalyptics now at the back with everybody focusing on her there, which allows Dutchland's jammer to get through. Dutchland looking good with Bella Lobolowski.
Et les deux jammers qui effectuent leur passage initial. Bella Lobolowski devant facilement. Il ne reste qu'une bloqueur. Je sais, trash and smash pour les New Kids. Little Mama revient sur la piste. Apocalyptic effectue son passage initial. Oh! Tête à queue dans Treasure Chest.
Looks like we had a major track cut from Spanish in Collision. So she has to sit to the penalty box. Penalties starting to apply much more heavily to Montreal all of a sudden. Uh-oh, Bella Lobolowski sent to the box.
C'est un super jump pour Apocalyptic.
Did not see the call, but he was moving his hands around quite vigorously. So Bella Lobolowski sent out for a major power jam right now. Montreal, 5 points just like that.
Et facilement à l'intérieur. Et on lui demande. Oui. Elle coupe la piste. Et c'était. It was a minor, I guess. She's awarded 5 points. Oh, what an odd call that was. Bella Lobolowski back on the track. And that's 5 points. 5 points for Bella Lobolowski. C'est un grand slam pour Dutchland.
You got about 10 seconds left. If Bella Lobolowski can get around one more time. Nice bump. Does not slow her down enough, though. Chasing Amy thinks she can get a piece of her, but Bella gets up into it. We'll have an update very quickly as to where our points stand. Looks like 4 points on that pass for Dutchland. And a timeout being called, I believe, by Montreal, but we will check. Indeed, it is. You know, Patrick, we have so many great sponsors. We always like to thank them. And we have a couple here that, you know, have been with us for a while and are just always on the edges of the track, always on the edges of the cultural norms that it is of roller derby. So we want to make sure that we thank Derby Skins, the original Shiny Heine. You can imitate them, you just can't duplicate them. We want to thank Wicked Skatewear. They love their sponsored leagues, Denver, Bay Area, Arizona, of course, Angel City. The great folks at Derbyology, Cub and Bear, purveyors of the Derby Unusual, purveyor of the actual shirt that I am wearing. They are the WFTDA TV Garmentry sponsor this year. If you want to be a sponsor, you can again go to WFTDA.tv/sponsorship. But if you want something more of a printed documentation for your league's printing and promotional needs, hit up printcographics.com, much like the hit we saw happening right there on our replay.
And still on a timeout, 386 for Montreal, 94 for Dutchland. And again, let me remind you, the winner will take on Boston tonight at 8 p.m. And the losing team will play about number 8.
We've got to follow our brackets here.
Tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock versus The losing team of DC versus Steel.
Yes, so our next game.
Coming right up, yes.
So it looks like Dutchland is going to go on to face DC or Steel tomorrow at 10 a.m. But later tonight, very logically, it looks like Montreal is going to be playing Boston at 8 p.m. Eastern. I think after this, we're all going to need a vacation, so I'm going to check out Union Vacations because they're the best way to save money, especially if you're looking for league travel. Union Vacations is proud to supply the winner of this year's Bracket Bonanza, speaking of brackets, with a trip for two to the 2013 WFTDA Championship Tournament.
And just to look at what's been happening between Boston and Montreal, because it looks like they're going to be facing each other tonight. This year, they played in July, Boston versus Montreal. Montreal took it 147-90. Overall, Montreal is 2-2 victories and 3 losses with Boston. And as far as Dutchland goes, they were up against Steel City this year. A very narrow loss, so 146-140, and they did not play DC, but they have played DC 4 times, and it was 2 victories and 2 losses. So a very evenly matched game either way. Mm-hmm. And this timeout still going on. Anybody getting ejected yet?
No.
No.
We've gotten close. Yeah, Bella Loblowski picked up her 5th on that last go.
Yeah, Treasure Chest is sitting at 5 over on the Montreal side.
Just the 4.
Bone Machine at 4. And Little Mama at 4, but that's about it. Mm-hmm. But I think both teams are going to want to reduce the number of power jams that they're awarding to the other team.
I think that's a definite factor. Yeah. You know, one of the other factors you have to consider is safety. If you want one of the safest and best helmets for Derby, that is S1. But again, it's not just about those factors, because it's also about the quality of your equipment. And if you want to check out an upgrade, possibly go to greenmonster.com. They are the makers of Antic Gumball Toe Stops, of course, Heartless Wheels, Reckless Wheels, Moto Bearings, Green Monster. They give you great derby products. And, of course, the most important thing you need in this sport, confidence. That is Green Monster.
And we're about to get underway again. Iron Wench had taken jam line. The only jammer on the track, Iron Wench pour Montréal, la seule jammeuse en piste. Et ça passe facilement pour Iron Wench, première jammeuse. C'est un super jam pour les New Kids.
Iron Wench, New Kids jammer, gets up into the inside of the pack and then slows very quickly because Dutchland has a nice bit of focus from the offense to the defense, waiting for their jammer to come back in. She is standing, but in the meantime, 5-point Grand Slam Montreal.
And Belle Blosky revient au jeu. Et facilement, ça passe à l'intérieur, le gros angle, surgical strike, essaie de faire le coup du match et ça ne fonctionne pas. Et maintenant, Iron Wench et Bella Ludlowski sont une derrière l'autre. Est-ce qu'Iron Wench arrête le jam? Non. Elle poursuit, je pense qu'elle veut faire un dernier passage. Oui. And she's trusting her blockers to hold back Bella Loblowski.
But I think that's been Montreal's strength a lot of this game, though, is that they can really let the jammers go out and do the point scoring. This is what they need to do.
But she still did pick up 4 points.
And I think that was great hustle there for Bella Loblowski. She's able to come out of the penalty box.
Yeah, I think it's important to say to anybody who wouldn't know this, but when the jam ends, the jammer, even though she did not leave the pack, you can add up all of the blockers that whose hips she passed at one point during that passage, during that pass. So even though she did not make it through the pack, if she passed a couple of blockers or all 4 blockers, but they recycle in front of her, that still gives her a point if the jam is called off. Georgia W. Tush contre Skid Ho pour Dutchland. The first jam for Georgia W. Tush this weekend.
Mm-hmm. She's been massively effective in the pack and doing just every bit as much damage on the track, wearing the star right now as she comes back around pack. Almost falls apart, but I think that's Montreal's plan. They want to back up, no pack. She's been working hard. Give her an easy one on this one, Georgie Dubinchuk. She just go skate, have some fun. She's able to pick up a 5-point pass on that. Dutchland's jammer is through. Viet Ho, number 18 in the black.
Georgia double touche pour un dernier passage. Arrête le jam aussitôt qu'elle est passée. Elle se prend 4 autres points. 0 pour Dutchland, ce qui nous amène à...
We want to thank Iron Doll Clothing, custom uniforms for the modern roller girl, and of course referee, lifting and separating since 2009. And you can certainly pair those up with roller bones and bones bearings. Always a winning combination. You just the complete ensemble. And if you want to take it to that next step, you could get some Adam Wheels because they are a proud partner and official wheel of the WFTDA, much like Rydell is the official skate. Unmatched quality, unmatched performance, unmatched generosity for the game, and love for the skaters and everybody here at the WFTDA. We run away in our, I'm going to go ahead and say this is last jam as we've got about 17 seconds left.
That's right. Iron Wench en piste pour les New Skids. Et oh! Collision avec l'arbitre. Toujours très populaire.
It's the pretty way of saying somebody just hit somebody. As we've got Dutchland through being waved off, of course, because that had been established. The question is, if you're Iron Wench, do you just keep skating the skater? No. You got to start planning for Boston.
The Iron Wench arrête le dernier jam. And Montreal picks up the victory. I think keeping Dutchland below 100 was a bit of a goal for them, as they did put up 413 points.
Well, as you had mentioned earlier, Dutchland suffering a rather substantial loss yesterday to Carolina. Carolina 304, Dutchland 75. So Dutchland a little bit higher, trying to get at least into triple digits, but Montreal saying, you know what, we came here to skate. We didn't bring the game we wanted yesterday, but I think they certainly did this morning.
Yeah, they did. They did. I think they're going to sit down and discuss the penalty issue, though, because Boston made a very strong case, as we were saying earlier, with their game against Philly yesterday, really controlling Philly throughout the first half and surprising everybody. And Montreal is going to, I think now they're going to sit down and say, okay, what can we do to get this penalty situation under control? They gave up, I think, 5 power jams throughout this game, and against the team that appears as menacing as Boston is this weekend, you know, that's going to get you into trouble.
Yes.
Double H standing here trackside with Bella Loblowski. Hard fought game.
Yeah. Tired.
Yeah. You look tired.
Yeah,
but you look
bit.
Beautiful. So, Dutchland, this season, you came in here, you're leaving winless. Last season, let's go back to 2011 playoffs for a minute.
Okay.
We had a very controversial moment at 2011 in Baltimore when your team decided to forfeit against Gotham.
Yeah.
We're in a situation here in Montreal with 413 as the score to your 98. How does that feel in comparison to the forfeit?
Well, I think at the time last year, we made the decision as a team and we thought it was the right decision at the time. I think looking back, knowing like the repercussions, maybe not so, but I still, you know, support my team and decisions we make as a team. You know, and this right here is we came with a lot of new girls and we wanted to get them the experience. You know, we wanted to bring our girls to build a team for next season. I think that's really important to get them the experience playing at this level. And I think it was good for them. I think it was good for everybody involved.
So you guys are out of Lancaster, PA. We say Lancaster, by the way, not Lancaster.
Yeah.
What do you got in store for next season aside from shoe fly pie?
Lots of training. I'm hoping to get these girls ready, you know, ready for what they have to come and hopefully, you know, regionals and, you know, everything. Lots of training. I don't know.
Shoe fly pie.
Some chow chow.
Yeah. So you guys came up with wins this season against teams like Maine, Dominion. Is that going to affect what you guys plan in terms of teams you play next season?
I'm actually not in charge of planning the season, so I really don't know. I would hope that we play hard teams. I really think we can. We just need to buckle down and get our up-and-coming girls ready. I think we can do it, though. You know, I have faith in these girls. They work really hard.
Well, you guys fought really hard on that track. The final score, Montreal 413, Dutchland 98.
Yeah,
but you guys fought your heart out.
Yeah,
thank you so
amazing.
Much.